It's been 10 years since an algal bloom caused a drinking water crisis in Toledo, Ohio, but blooms in Lake Erie remain a problem. We reported on the issue 5 years after the crisis, and a solution has not materialized. Here's a recap of our earlier coverage and an update.
What's become the new normal is severe toxic algae outbreaks in western Lake Erie.
Howard Lerner is the president and executive director of the Environmental Law and Policy Center in Chicago. And for the second time in 5 years, the organization is suing the US EPA on behalf of Lake Erie.
That impairs clean water, it harms fisheries, it interferes with tourism and outdoor recreation, and it makes Toledo and Northwest Ohio a much less pleasant place to be.
Ed Verhamy is an environmental engineer at LimnoTech, which maintains a network of sensors that monitor water quality in Lake Erie.
The bloom here goes out about 12 miles offshore. As far as the eye can see, the water's green. And if you look real close, you can actually see the algal colony. It's not like a dye or a stain. It's the water's green because all the algae are there.
The blooms that we're seeing in Lake Erie represent an unnatural flux of nutrients. When you have lots of nutrients and you have warm temperatures in the summertime and you have calm waters, that is conducive to the growth of bloom-forming bacteria, cyanobacteria, that grow to really high densities and that produce molecules that are of concern due to their toxicity.
In August of 2014, those molecules would make national headlines.
Ohio's governor declaring a state of emergency after routine testing early Friday showed the city's water supply had been contaminated by toxins known as microcystins.
There was a very large algal bloom that sat out very close to the water intake crib, but the city didn't really know that the bloom was there until they started sucking it into their water intake, and the bad water was already at the plant.
For now, nearly 500,000 people go into the work week without being able to drink water from their taps, and businesses are expected to remain closed.
To prevent more crises, the city of Toledo made expensive upgrades to their water plant. Toledo Mayor Wade Kapsakevich.
Fortunately now, 5 years after the Toledo water crisis, we have invested so much money into our Collins Park water treatment plant that we can take water that looks like this. By the time it gets to your faucet, it really is among the best drinking water that you can get anywhere in North America. But it is a shame that the ratepayers of Northwest Ohio have had to reach into their pocket for the $500 million over the last couple years needed to turn this into world-class drinking water. And by the way, there is no mystery anymore as to who is causing this problem. Every scientific study of this problem has reached an absolute unanimous consensus that this is a problem caused primarily by agricultural runoff and agricultural interests.
The Maumee River watershed drains 5,000 square miles within Ohio, 80% of which is used for agriculture. Phosphorus is a key mineral needed for crop growth, and lots of it is applied to fields in the form of fertilizer and manure. But when rain washes it off of fields and into the river, and the river delivers it to Lake Erie, phosphorus can boost the growth of cyanobacteria and fuel algae blooms.
What we know from the Ohio EPA and other data is that more than 90% of the phosphorus that gets into western Lake Erie comes from agricultural runoff. And that's really from two places. That's CAFOs, that's concentrated animal feedlot operations with thousands and thousands of chickens and pigs and cattle. And then that's fertilizer that's spread on the corn and soy fields. Rainstorm comes, it runs off, it gets into the tributaries which go into the Maumee River and then make their way into western Lake Erie.
Those nutrients are running off into the water and the bacteria are able to acquire as much of this nutrient as they need, and they're able to grow almost uncontrollably. So they're able to grow to these really high densities that results in these large amounts of biomass that produce these toxins of concern.
Jeff Reuter is the former director of the Ohio Sea Grant Program at Ohio State University.
The way that really drives the concentration of phosphorus up is applying too much manure. We now know that the vast majority of the manure is spread within 2 miles of a barn, so we tend to have over application of manure very close to animal operations. and that leads to excessively high concentrations. I am 100% comfortable in telling you that the animal operations are allowed to apply more than four times the amount that's needed for maximum crop production.
Many citizens believed the water crisis in 2014 would be a wake-up call leading to action. And in 2015, the states of Michigan and Ohio, as well as the province of Ontario, committed to a 40% reduction in total phosphorus flowing into Lake Erie by 2025. Across the watershed, agencies promoted voluntary practices farmers could adopt to reduce runoff. Several years in, concentrations of phosphorus entering Lake Erie were still the same. But in 2019, researchers got a preview of what can happen when fertilizer and manure application is suddenly and significantly reduced. Chris Winslow is the current director of the Ohio Sea Grant Program.
The fall of 2018 was very, very wet, meaning farmers couldn't do a lot of the things that they would do in the fall to prepare for the next growing season. And then the spring of 2019 was very, very wet. And so what we know is farmers, producers, just could not get out in the field. Half of the fertilizer that is normally purchased in a growing season was actually purchased. Only about 15% of manure that is typically applied got applied.
So the amount of phosphorus applied to the fields went down by 62%. And in the runoff, we saw a 29% reduction in flow-weighted mean concentration. So we were essentially three-quarters of the way to our target. We detected that reduction immediately. What that tells me, one thing, it's we're gonna see an immediate reduction if we apply less, but the other thing that it tells me, legacy fields, or these agricultural fields that have excessive amounts of phosphorus already on them, they are an important piece of the problem. Because we reduced the load by 62%, we should have seen a larger than a 29% reduction in the amount of phosphorus coming in.
In 2019, frustrated with the state's focus on voluntary action, the Environmental Law and Policy Center and the Board of Commissioners of Lucas County, home to the city of Toledo, sued the US EPA. They sought a cap on phosphorus entering the Maumee watershed by implementing Section 303 of the Clean Water Act, regulatory pollution control known as a total maximum daily load, or TMDL. In 2023, that lawsuit ended in a consent decree requiring the Ohio EPA to submit a plan for a TMDL to the US EPA, which approved Ohio's plan in 2024.
It took a lawsuit to force the US EPA to force the Ohio EPA to develop a TMDL.
Fritz Byers is outside legal counsel for the Lucas County Board of Commissioners, a party to the lawsuit in 2019. They feel Ohio's TMDL plan is too weak.
We all know that Ohio's TMDL relies for the most part on voluntary compliance measures and ignores the science of what's causing the harmful algal blooms. Hence, yesterday, we had to file yet another lawsuit. The parties in this lawsuit are the Board of Lucas County Commissioners, the City of Toledo, and the Environmental Law and Policy Center. We want, yet again, for the federal court to look directly at the US EPA and say, you have violated the law, you have violated your own regulations by approving Ohio's TMDL. Revoke your approval to create an effective remedial plan. There's no reasonable doubt that there's only one way to address the impairment of the western basin of Lake Erie, and that is to create a, quote, pollution diet that regulates the amount of dissolved reactive phosphorus that gets discharged in the first instance into the Maumee watershed and that eventually gets discharged into Lake Erie.
Not everyone is on board a TMDL. Agricultural interest groups and people close to the agricultural community worry that greater restrictions could hurt farmers.
Whenever you use a reg, there are always these gray areas, and there's often unintended consequences of those regs. And I will tell you, just from working with producers and farmers, one of those is going to be the cost of doing business. And so I have a hard time wrapping my brain around any reg. There's just too many variables and too many things out there that are going to make it very difficult.
Jordan Howisher is the Director of Water Quality and Research at the Ohio Farm Bureau Federation.
I took the job with Farm Bureau after Toledo's water crisis, and I asked one question: are we going to be deniers of our role, you know, as the predominant landowners in this watershed? And they said, no, we're going to be at the table. There's a lot of things that come into play here. It's not to take away from what Toledo has done for their citizens, but we focus on what farmers can do on their piece of land. And it's an extremely, extremely tough business to be in because they are reliant on markets that oftentimes are really against them.
They're looking at best management practices that would allow us to continue to apply too much fertilizer rather than a regulation that would prevent the application.
There are a lot of lobbyists that want to fight against these reforms that have strong vested interests in the status quo. And there are massive money machines behind this. But there's no electoral activity behind this. And that's why I'm hopeful. All we're trying to do is get our governments to honor their promises that they have made to us and that they have made internationally in our name.
In a written response to our request for comment, US EPA replied, EPA received the lawsuit from the city of Toledo. Addressing the problem of algal blooms in the western basin of Lake Erie will take all of us. It will take unflagging commitment and resolve, and it will take time.